Welcome to the presentation of image restoration and noise models. In this presentation, first we'll see the introduction, then we'll see model of image degradation or restoration process, then we'll see various noise models, that is Gaussian noise, relay noise, exponential noise, uniform noise, and impulse or salt and pepper noise. Now first, the introduction. Restoration attempts to reconstruct or recover an image that has been degraded by using a prior knowledge of the degradation phenomenon. Thus, restoration techniques are oriented toward modeling degradation and applying the inverse process in order to recover the original image. This approach usually involves formulating a criterion of goodness that will yield an optimal estimate of the desired result. By contrast, enhancement techniques basically are designed to manipulate an image in order to take advantage of the psychophysical aspects of the human visual system. For example, contrast stretching is considered an enhancement technique because it is based primarily on the pleasing aspect it might present to the viewer, whereas removal of image blur by applying a deblurring function is considered a restoration technique. Now we'll see a model of the image degradation or restoration process. As shown in this figure, the degradation process is modeled as a degradation function that, together with an additive noise term, operates on an image f of xy to produce a degraded image g of xy. Given g of xy, some knowledge about the degradation function h and some knowledge about the additive noise eta of xy, the objective of restoration is to obtain an estimate f cap xy of the original image. If h is a linear position invariant process, then the degraded image is given in the spatial domain by g of xy is equal to h of xy into f of xy plus eta of xy, where h of xy is a spatial representation of the degradation function and the symbol asterisk indicates convolution. We know that convolution in the spatial domain is equal to multiplication in the frequency domain. Thus, equation 1 in an equivalent frequency domain representation is g of uv is equal to h of uv into f of uv plus n of uv, where the terms in capital letters are Fourier transforms of the corresponding term in equation 1. Now, the next is noise models. The principal sources of noise in digital images arise during image acquisition, that is digitization, and or transmission. The performance of image sensors is affected by a variety of factors such as environmental conditions during image acquisition and by the quality of the sensing elements themselves. For instance, in acquiring images with a CCD camera, light levels and sensor temperature are major factors affecting the amount of noise in the resulting image. Images are corrupted during transmission principally due to interference in the channel used for transmission. For example, an image transmitted using a wireless network might be corrupted as a result of lightning or other atmospheric disturbance. Spatial and frequency properties of noise. Frequency properties refer to the frequency content of noise in Fourier sense, that is, as opposed to the electromagnetic spectrum. For example, when the Fourier spectrum of noise is constant, The noise usually is called white noise. This terminology is a carryover from the physical properties of white light, which contains nearly all frequencies in the visible spectrum in proportions. Here, we assume that noise is independent of spatial coordinates and it is uncorrelated with respect to the image itself. That is, there is no correlation between pixel values and the values of noise components. Some important noise probability functions. Based on the assumptions in the previous section, the spatial noise descriptor with which we shall be concerned is the statistical behavior of the gray level values in the noise component of the model in Figure 1. These may be considered random variables characterized by a probability density function, that is PDF. The following are the most common PDFs found in image processing applications. Number 1, Gaussian noise, next relay noise, exponential noise, uniform noise, and impulse, that is salt and pepper noise. First is the Gaussian noise. Because of its mathematical traceability in both the spatial and frequency domains, Gaussian, also called normal noise models, are used frequently in practice. In fact, this traceability is so convenient that it often results in Gaussian models being used in situations in which they are marginally applicable at best. The PDF of Gaussian random variable Z is given by P of Z is equal to 1 upon square root of 2 pi sigma into e raised to Z minus mu divided by 2 sigma square, where Z represents the gray level, mu is the mean of average value of Z, and sigma is the standard deviation. The standard deviation squared sigma square is the variance of Z. A plot of Gaussian noise function is shown here in this figure. When Z is described by equation 3, approximately 70% of its values will be in the range mu minus sigma and mu plus sigma, and about 95% will be in the range mu minus 2 sigma to mu plus 2 sigma. Next is relay noise. The PDF of relay noise is given by P of Z is equal to 2 upon B into Z minus A into e raised to minus Z minus A square divided by B, for Z is greater than or equal to A. Otherwise, it is equal to 0 for Z is less than A. The mean and variance of this density are given by mu is equal to A plus square root of pi B divided by 4. Similarly, variance sigma square is equal to B into 4 minus pi divided by 4. Here, this figure shows a plot of relay density. Note the displacement from the origin and the fact that the basic shape of this density is skewed to the right. The relay density can be quite useful for approximating skewed histograms. Exponential noise. The PDF of exponential noise is given by P of Z is equal to A into e raised to minus AZ for Z is greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise, it is 0 for Z is less than 0. Where A greater than 0, the mean and variance of this density function are mu is equal to 1 upon A and sigma square is equal to 1 upon A square. Here, the figure shows a plot of this density function. Uniform noise. The PDF of uniform noise is given by P of Z is equal to 1 upon B minus A for A less than or equal to Z less than or equal to B. Otherwise, P of Z is equal to 0. The mean of this density function is given by mu is equal to a plus b upon 2 and its variance sigma square is equal to b minus a square divided by 12. Again here the figure shows a plot of uniform density. Impulse noise or salt and pepper noise. The PDF of bipolar impulse noise is given by P of Z is equal to PA for Z equal to A, it is equal to PB for Z equal to B, otherwise it is equal to 0. If B is greater than gray level, B will appear as a light dot in the image. Conversely, level A will appear like a dark dot. If either PA or PB is 0, the impulse noise is called unipolar. If neither, probability is 0, and especially if they are approximately equal, impulse noise values will resemble salt and pepper granules randomly distributed over the image. For this reason, bipolar impulse noise also is called salt and pepper noise or shot and spike noise. Gaussian noise arises in an image due to factors such as electronic circuit noise and sensor noise due to poor illumination and high temperature. The relay density is helpful in characterizing noise phenomena in range imaging. The exponential densities find application in laser imaging. Impulse noise is found in situations where quick transients such as faulty switching take place during imaging. The uniform density is perhaps the least descriptive of practical situations. Here is the end of this presentation. Thank you.